Hello, this is your daily dose of news from On Manorama. I'm your host Swati Ajit and these are the major news stories of Monday, June 3rd, 2024. India created a world record with 64.2 crore voters, including 31.2 crore women, participating in the Lok Sabha elections this year, Chief Election Commissioner Rajiv Kumar said. The seven-phase polling for all 543 Lok Sabha constituencies across 28 states and 8 union territories ended on Saturday, with the results to be declared on June 4th, Tuesday. A group of United Nations experts called on Monday for all countries to recognize a Palestinian state to ensure peace in the Middle East. Claudia Sheinbaum, a Nobel Prize-winning climate scientist, will become Mexico's first female president after winning a landslide election victory. India saw nearly 25,000 cases of suspected heat stroke and 56 people lost their lives after several heatwave days across the country from March to May, according to government data. Let's get into the details. India created a world record with 64.2 crore voters, including 31.2 crore women, participating in the Lok Sabha elections this year, Chief Election Commissioner Rajiv Kumar said on Monday. Addressing a press briefing, he said over 68,000 monitoring teams and 1.4 crore polling and security personnel were involved in the world's largest electoral exercise. Rajiv Kumar also dared the opposition to share evidence of allegations that returning officers and district magistrates were influenced to corrupt the poll process so the panel could take action against them. The opposition should also tell the commission about those trying to influence the poll process before the counting of vote begins, Kumar said at a press conference. He was flanked by election commissioners Gyanesh Kumar and S.S. Sandhu. The months-long election season has come to an end and the nation is poised to find out who will form the government for the next 5 years, with vote counting scheduled for Tuesday, June 4th. Voting for all 543 Lok Sabha constituencies occurred in seven phases, starting on April 19th and concluding on June 1st, with the results to be declared on June 4th. The Election Commission of India has made elaborate arrangements for the vote counting, which will begin at 8 a.m. on Tuesday, with the results expected to start rolling out by noon. Under the leadership of Prime Minister Narendra Modi, the National Democratic Alliance, led by the Bharatiya Janata Party, is eyeing a third consecutive term at the centre. On the other side is the India bloc, which includes the Congress and dozens other non-BJP parties. A group of United Nations experts called on Monday for all countries to recognise a Palestinian state to ensure peace in the Middle East. The call came less than a week after Spain, Ireland and Norway officially recognised a Palestinian state, prompting anger from Israel, which has found itself increasingly isolated after nearly 8 months of war in Gaza. Israel has repeatedly condemned moves to recognise a Palestinian state, saying they bolster Hamas, the militant Islamist group that led the deadly October 7 attack on Israel, which sparked the Israeli offensive in the Gaza Strip. Claudia Sheinbaum from the ruling leftist Morena party made history by becoming the country's first female president in a landslide victory. Sheinbaum, a climate scientist and former mayor of Mexico City, won the presidency with between 58.3% and 60.7% of the vote, according to a rapid sample code by Mexico's electoral authority. This is said to be the highest vote tally percentage in Mexico's democratic history. Victory for Sheinbaum is a major step for Mexico, a country known for its macho culture and home to the world's second biggest Roman Catholic population, which for years pushed more traditional values and roles for women. India saw nearly 25,000 cases of suspected heat stroke and 56 people lost their lives after several heatwave days across the country from March to May, according to government data. May has been a terrible month for the region, with temperature in capital Delhi and the nearby state of Rajasthan touching 50 degrees Celsius. However, the weather department has predicted that the early arrival of monsoon in Kerala is expected to bring more relief. In contrast, parts of eastern India have been reeling under the impact of Cyclone Rimal. Heavy rain in the northeast state of Assam has killed 14 people since Tuesday. That brings us to the end of this episode. Thanks for listening to Daily News Dose, hosted by me, Swati Ajit, and produced by Vishnu Murlitharan, with technical support from Idea Brew Studios. Follow www.onmanorama.com for detailed updates on the latest news and be sure to come back tomorrow.